Good morning, everybody, and happy Friday's gone past. Sorry, hadn't been in touch here lately, but we've had a lot going on. Figured I'd try to catch everybody up. Starting on November the 9th, on a Friday, me and my daddy spent time at the HPH Hospital with my mama. Yep, difference was, my mama wasn't the one in there in the surgery room working. She was laying in the bed being the patient. That's a different tune.
Say something.
But she had some work done on her neck, and she feels much better now. Me and Daddy just hung out in the car. Yeah, you know, you can do those kind of things nowadays with all this new technology they got. They actually paid you whenever you can come in and see the patient and let you know, as things progress, what's going on. Telling you, it's just unreal what they can do with phones these days.
They text you whenever your patient is ready. Well, when your family member's ready. Technology today, Jay. So we're just kind of hanging out, listening to a little music. Yeah, I know. Mama's in there. Oh, I know. Mama's in there getting them. Yeah. Mama's in there getting her neck work.
I'm alone tonight, and chances are you're sitting here in this bar, cause he ain't gonna treat you right. Well, it's probably not my place,
your
but I'm gonna say it anyway, cause you look like,
yeah,
you haven't felt the fight.
Love you, mama.
A little fun,
can I have a kiss?
Had a smile.
Jack,
in
can
a
I have a kiss?
While,
give me a kiss.
Baby. But I don't understand how another man can take your son and turn it ice cold.
Your mama at?
God, I sure love my mama. And everything went very well with her procedure. And that makes me a very happy little puppy. So, on to the next Friday, me and Daddy went down and watched another beautiful sunrise. My daddy's always telling me I'm a badass, but holy pig's lard. Take a good look at my daddy's fat ass in this video. That's nothing but pure lard, my friends. I love my daddy, but he needs to do something about that balloon. I'm just saying.
I'm Earl Devils Jr. I'm a country boy. Of course I work hard. People don't know if I've got a schedule or not, but I do. I got a tough schedule.
Now, on Thanksgiving Friday, we had, like, the Adventures of the Swamp People at Bayshore Park, which is just within rock's throw of our house. There was a 12-foot alligator in the Galveston Bay. Yes, that's what I said, a 12-foot alligator. So, our Galveston County's finest, our Sheriff's Department, had already contacted an official gator trapper, hunter, whatever you want to call him. He's from Louisiana. Not sure about his name, but we're just going to call him Gator Boy. Now, I'm telling you, this was not Gator Boy's first rodeo. Oh no. He was what you call a professional, and had Gator Girl with him. Actually, Gator Girl's his wife. So, after several attempts, Gator Boy finally lassos the beast. And I say beast because I wouldn't even be an appetizer for this thing. It would be like eating just one of them little chicken drummies from Hooters. My daddy loves Hooters. That's all I'm going to say about that. Once a fight was on, he hollered up and said, "I'm gonna need some help, boys." Well, my Uncle John is like what Jimmy Dean wrote a song about many years ago called Big John. He's a hell of a man. He like stood 6'6", weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulders and there at the hips, and everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John. Big John, Big John. Well, my Uncle John ain't too narrow at the hips. Well, Uncle John had the end of the rope pulling on the gator, and they got him up on the bank. And after that, we named my Uncle John Tugboat. I love my Uncle John. So Gator Boy tells us this gator is over 100 years old. And sadly, he had basically come up in that area to die. Gator Boy said they typically don't live in salt water, but said this old gator had been in it for a while because he had barnacles on his back. This old gator was missing an eye and his back foot. Gator Boy said he had probably lost his foot when he was very young. Gator Boy actually lives in Santa Fe, Texas now, and of course all the onlookers were asking, what's going to happen to Mr. Gator? He said, well, he's dying now. What do you think we're going to do with him? We're going to eat him. You got to love his honesty. Well, wanted to touch base with everybody and wish everyone a wonderfully blessed weekend. So for now, this is JJ sending love to all from sunny San Leon.
This is the Country Boy song. Yeah, this is the Country Boy song. Put a good dip in.